Hi there, Rachel here. Today we'll be moving through an anxiety calming sequence for those heart racing, mind chattering moments of your life. Buddhist author Natalie Goldberg writes, "Stress is basically a disconnection from the earth, a forgetting of the breath. Stress is an ignorant state. It believes that everything is an emergency. Nothing is that important. Just lie down." She's right. Learning to manage our feelings is one of the most challenging projects of being human. Many of us didn't grow up doing it well. And yoga can be a tool for learning to choose to respond consciously and wholeheartedly to our moments of anxiety, rather than reacting unconsciously to them or trying to numb them out by diving into a pint of ice cream or cracking open a bottle of wine. In those moments of your life wherein your mind races and your breath catches in your throat and you figure there is no way you could possibly feel still or calm again, hit the floor, literally. Drop to the ground and fold forward into child's pose. Take as many long, deep, slow breaths there as you need. In each of these poses, you'll find a measure of stillness, an opportunity to slow down. So trust your body. It can calm itself. Trust your breath to take you out of your chattering, spinning monkey mind and back into your body. You can come back to center. The waves will pass. You are the still small voice of calm and reason in the midst of all the crashing waves. You are just learning how to surf. And so finally, don't worry. You can't mess this up. You made it to the mat already. And in a difficult moment, that's a victory in and of itself. So give yourself credit. If your mind races, and it will, give yourself a mantra to literally yoke your thoughts to your breath. As you inhale, think to yourself, let, and as you exhale, go. Another mantra I find helpful is, as I inhale, think, here, and as I exhale, now. So let's move into the practice. Come onto your mat and settle into child's pose. Let your knees open up wide. Your belly can stay soft, pressing your hips to your heels as you reach your arms long out in front of you. Now, if your forehead easily touches the mat, great. If your forehead struggles to touch, grab your block, and you can always rest your forehead right on your block. A final variation, if you prefer, would be to wrap the arms around your calves, bringing your forehead to the mat. Wherever you are, stay here for three more breaths, maybe rocking your forehead right and left to massage away any tension in your brow. From here, keep your chest low and start to walk your arms toward the left corner of the room, stretching your torso long over your left thigh and maybe picking up the right hand, placing it on top of the left. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, feel your right hip press a little closer to your right heel. And let's take three breaths. Lift your head, and for your second side, walk your arms to the right corner of the room,
Stretching over your right thigh and maybe picking up the left hand and placing it on top of the right. Taking three breaths. Coming back to center, arms long, one last breath. From here, inhale to all fours, tabletop. Stacking shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. For cat, exhale, bring your chin to your chest and hollow your belly. And now inhale for cow as you drop your belly, eyes and tailbone up. Again, exhale, cat, hollow. Through your nose, inhale, cow. Three more rounds. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Again, exhale, press the floor away. Inhale, cow. Final breath. Exhale, hollow. Inhale, cow. Bring your spine to neutral. Keep the left hand down. Inhale, reach the right arm up, really stretching here. And then exhale to thread the needle, taking the right arm under the left armpit and the left arm forward. Now you can stay here, or if you'd like, you can wrap the left arm behind your back, tucking your fingers in your hip. And here too, if this doesn't feel reasonable, grab your block, and you can always rest your right ear on that block. So wherever you are, stay, breathing into it for three. Two. And from here, slowly begin to press back up to all fours. Keep the right hand down. Inhale, the left arm long. Exhale, left hand under the right armpit. Left ear down. Right arm can reach forward, or you can wrap it behind your back, tucking the fingers in your hip. Breathing here for three. Two. Last breath. Inhale. Place the right hand on the mat as you press up to all fours. And then from here, for down dog, curl your toes under, lift your knees, and slide into that upside down V shape. Taking five good breaths here. Feel free to bend one knee and then bend the other. Making sure you have lots of space between every finger and the sides of the feet are parallel to the sides of the mat. You're looking between your big toes, neck nice and relaxed. Last two. Final breath. From here, walk your hands toward your feet at the back of the mat. Bend your knees a little, grab hold of your elbows, and just sway like a rag doll, right and left. Bending one knee, bending the other, shaking your head out, opening and closing your jaw, really unraveling. And then coming back to center, release your arms, bring your toes and heels to touch, bending your knees, reach back. Clasp hands behind your tailbone and begin to fold forward, tucking your face just beneath your knees. Bend the knees as much as you need to here. Breathing for three. Two. Last breath. Carefully release your arms and walk it back out, downward facing dog. Taking one breath here. From dog, step your right foot forward between your hands. Place both hands inside the right foot and walk your hands between your feet to the middle of the mat. Now, if the floor feels far away, you can always place a block under your hands. Otherwise,
Hands on the mat. Inhale, look forward. And then exhale, deepen your fold. Prasarita Paddhatanasana, A variation. If you prefer, you can grab hold of your big toes. Inhale to lengthen, and then exhale, deepen. Growing the crown of your head toward the floor as you roll your shoulders back and down from your ears. Last two. Final breath. From here, lift your head, hands to the mat. And for a deep yogi squat, bring your feet closer together, turning your toes out, your heels in, palms in prayer. And if this doesn't feel reasonable in your body, again, grab your block. You can sit on your block at any height. You can also use a blanket or roll your mat to pad your heels. So find your variation, palms in prayer, and then maybe close your eyes. Breathing here as you spread your toes wide, feeling your heels, your big toes, your baby toes, every corner of your foot sink into the floor, growing tall through the crown of your head. Ground. Last breath. From here, eyes open, hands to the mat, lift your hips, and come back to downward facing dog. Pedal your legs a little here if you'd like. Feeling the blood rush back to your hips, your knees, your ankles. And then look forward and come to sit on your heels. So this is hero pose. And if this already feels unreasonable for your knees, or if you have a history of injuries, again, you can grab your block, have a seat. Take that pressure off your knees. If your knees and your ankles are healthy and you want a little more, lift your hips, place your hips on the mat between your heels, and then check in with your body. Looking at your knees, make sure they continue to press down. If they do start to spread apart, that's a good clue that you should stop. So this might be your pose. If you're willing to go further and you think your knees are healthy and up for it, look forward. Place your right hand on your right heel, hand on left heel. Lower back down onto forearms and elbows, maybe staying here, especially if the knees pop up. Your final variation might be to come all the way down, reach back, and grab hold of the elbows behind your head. So wherever you are now, close your eyes if you'd like. And just watch whatever comes up, watching the inhale. Watching the exhale. Again, watch the inhale. Watch the exhale. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale. If you're reclining, hands to feet, gently begin to press up, lifting your heart. Hands on your thighs, and then everybody look forward, plant your hands on the mat, and step back, downward facing dog. If you'd like, take a big inhalation, open your mouth, and exhale. From here, bend your knees, look forward, and walk through to your seat, extending your legs out long. From here, draw the left knee in, and then let it fall open. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, fold forward over your straight right leg. Inhale to lift, and then exhale, deepen. If you prefer, or if your hamstrings are tight, go ahead and grab your strap or a scarf or a towel or whatever you have. Use that to get your grip. And think about reaching your forehead past your big toe. Lengthen, inhale. Deepen, exhale. Taking two more breaths, inhale. Last breath. From here, lift your head, arms reach forward, inhale up, Exhale, palms to prayer, release. Second side, left knee in. Extend that leg up long. Draw the right knee in, let it fall open. From here, inhale, arms up. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, lift. Exhale, deepen. Here too, feeling free to use your strap. Tall spine as you hinge at the hips. Maintaining that length in the spine, even as you fold forward. Stay here, two more breaths. Inhale. Last breath. Lift your head, arms reach forward, inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, palms through prayer, release. From here, hug both knees into your chest. Let the knees fall open, soles of the feet touch. Bring your thumbs to your arches. And if this doesn't feel reasonable, you can also sit on your block here. From here, inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Noticing the difference here between a flat spine and a curved spine. You want a nice tall spine, maintaining a lift in your collarbone. Continue to fold forward, breathing here for three. Two. Last breath. Lift your head, inhale, come back up. Hands outside your thighs, guide your knees together, and then grab your block for a supported bridge. Lay down, separating your feet hip distance, and place the block under your hips. Fingers can reach toward your heels. It can also feel nice to reach your arms long behind you if you'd like. From here, take an inhale. Open your mouth, exhale. Resting in the stillness. Toes spread wide. Feeling your heart beating in your chest. Your body breathing itself without you having to tell it to do so. Remembering what a miracle that is in and of itself. From here, lift your hips, sliding the block out. Keep your hips down, bringing the soles of the feet to touch as the knees fall open for Supta Baddha Konasana. Left hand on your belly, right hand on your heart. Again here, taking five long breaths. Feeling the connection of your shoulders, your hips, your feet to the earth. Knowing you are of the earth. Feeling the breath and the life coursing through your veins. Knowing that whatever it is that feels scary or uncertain or menacing will pass. And that this beating heart, these breathing lungs, are here to sustain you. From here, hands outside your thighs, guide your knees together, hugging your knees into your chest. For happy baby, bring your fingers to your arches, and you can rock your baby a little bit if you want. Maybe stacking the heels over the knees, and then coming to center. Again, a nice steady pressure on the arches of the feet, pressing the belly button through your spine down into the mat. Last breath. Hugging your knees into your chest, take a little lift, and then drop your knees to the left, looking over your right shoulder. Taking this reclining twist, breathing, lengthening, inhale. Deepen, exhale. Three more breaths. Two. Last breath. From here, inhale, knees to center. Take a little lift. Exhale, second side. Dropping your knees to the right as you look over your left. Close your eyes if you'd like. Breathing here. Really drawing your knees as close to your right armpit as you can. For three. Two. Last breath. Inhale, bring the knees back to center. And now, one more time, grab your block. And for a variation on legs at the wall, slide your block under your hips. This time, extend your legs to the ceiling, flexing your toes down to your face. Now, from here, you can take your arms out wide. Or if you'd like, you could bring your left hand to your belly again, right hand to your heart. Staying here in this restorative pose. For seven. Remembering as you inhale here, as you exhale now. Again, inhale, exhale. Letting anything you're feeling frightened about, anxious about, drain out through your fingertips. That you might come into this still, calm, peaceful place. Remembering that is your natural state. Last breath. Moving slowly, bend your knees. Place your feet on the floor so you can remove your block. One more time, hug your knees into your chest, inhale, and then exhale, release, dropping right into your Shavasana. Feet floppy, legs loose, palms fall open, settling the weight of your hips and your shoulders. And then one last time, taking a big inhalation. Open your mouth, exhale. Slowly beginning to breathe back into your fingers. Wake up your toes. Softening the breath through your ankles, into your knees. Easing into your hips and your belly. Softening up through your heart, your shoulders, and all the way out through the crown of your head. And then from here, reaching back, interlacing your fingers. Lengthen your legs long as you inhale. And then exhale, release. One at a time, gently guiding your knees in close. And then softly rolling onto your side, I'm taking a final breath here in stillness. And as you're ready, gently beginning to press back up to your seats, keeping your eyes closed, lips sealed. And once you've settled in here a little bit, drop your head to the right, taking a loose, heavy circle. And then reverse, swing it to the left. Finally bringing everything back to center, inhaling palms to prayer. We'll take one final om. Inhaling here. Om. Inhaling here in the silence, we lift our hearts. And exhaling, we bow forward in very simple gratitude for this body, this breath, this moment, and this life. For as the yoga reminds us, each of these will pass, that we might never take any of those breaths or any of those moments, even and especially the most awkward and frustrating ones, for granted. Inhaling, we rise up. My friends, my teachers, namaste. Thank you so much for practicing today. You have given yourself a gift. Until next time, be well.